It's Asaph. And welcome to Wake Up Missoula. I am your host, Scott Ramp.
And I'm also your host, Noelle McFoy. That was Asaph Adonai on piano. With that very, what was that tune, Asaph?
That is a song called I'm Bringing Home a Baby Bumblebee.
Ooh, nice. Yes. Nice. That was a fun little lively tune for our Wednesday morning.
Yep, we have a great show for you guys today. We have one new program happening tonight, but of course, don't worry about it. We have some city council. And, you know, I said that they would be talking about the Merck, but apparently, the one thing that overshadowed it was the emergency ordinance that was implied for the parking commission. So I'll talk about more about the parking commission and their new ordinance. Beyond that, I have some Hallmark or Bullmark, and you have some good events.
Oh yeah, yeah, there is so much happening, you guys. I was amazed. Holy cow. Mm-hmm.
And Gallery of the Visual Arts at the University of Montana, Rick gave me a 3-part video, but of course it's ending this Friday.
So you have 2 days to go there.
So I'm going to show you as much of that as I can, along with the Clay Studios, which is ending this Friday. So there's like 4 art clips. 3 art clips I haven't shown you, so you're 75% blind.
Yeah.
But don't be blind from the weather, because it's looking like it's going to be a little foggy today. You can expect, it is currently 33 degrees outside. You have a high chance of 47, so it's not going to be too cold. But of course, your low is going to be 32, so it's just about freezing. And of course, you're going to have shattered showers, then some scattered rain and snow mixtures. And then of course, tonight's going to be mostly cloudy, then a chance, 30% chance of snow. Thursday, it goes up to 60%. And then of course, Thursday night, you can expect your 80% chance of snow. So of course, you can expect snow happening later this week. And hopefully this weekend, by Sunday, you can expect things to be sunny.
Yes,
The name implies.
Yeah, hopefully.
Funny how that works out.
But you know, you guys, if it's raining or snowing down here, it is definitely snowing up on the mountains. So Whitefish has got 1 inch of new snow in the past 24 hours. Their lower base depth is 25 inches, and their upper base depth is 108 inches. Blacktail Mountain has got 5 inches in the past 24 hours, 28 inches on the bottom, 93 inches up top. Looks like Snowball has got 0 inches new snow, and Lost Trail's got 0 inches new snow, but Discovery has 1 inch of new snow.
Cool.
So yeah, it looks like that we still have a couple weeks left of skiing. So get out there, everyone.
But of course, we do have a new program, and it is a percussion concert.
Oh.
And for some reason, I totally spaced on putting the time when it is going to be on MCAT tonight. So I'll just quickly look at it. So it's an evening of music for percussion and piano, and that's happening tonight at 10. So if you guys want to stay up a little later than usual, you guys can check out this little tease from tonight's percussion. For tonight,
yeah.
It's happening at 10 p.m. channel 189 on MCAT.
That's gonna be great.
But of course, you can find out more information about Wake Up Missoula by logging on to our website, wakeupmissoula.wix. That's wix.com/wakeupmissoula. So nice for me to spell it out twice, and I'm also really cheap to buy the wakeupmissoula.com or .org. You can also like us on our Facebook page, Wake Up Missoula. Wake Up Missoula is also on Twitter, at Wake Up Missoula.
You can like Missoula Community Access Television on Twitter, at MCAT TV Missoula. You can also like MCAT on Facebook. And to find out more information about us, just check us out at MCAT.org.
Yep.
Yeah.
That's great.
One thing about our website, though, is our thumbnails for our show is always my face in, like, the dumbest expression. It's been like that for the past month. I'm sick of it. I'm done. Right there, I'm just like...
I guess we may have to stop doing those close-ups on your face for...
Still do the close-ups, of course. I need a close-up. But you can change the thumbnail in YouTube.
Yeah, but that's only after the fact. And usually when it's already kind of out there, even if you can watch
it
online, the thumbnail, it won't give you the option of thumbnail until after like 30 or 40 minutes after the video is officially up and ready to go. So I'm usually out the door.
Yeah, that's true. Oh, well, I guess I'll just have to stop complaining. But it's still, I don't know, whatever. But it's Wednesday, you guys, middle of the week. I am so excited. I hope you guys have had a good week so far. I know I have.
It's been great. Yeah. And before we go over to events, we're going to show a little nice little art clip from the Gallery of the Visual Arts. And stay with us. We have some more show right after this.
Students do some cool stuff. All right, so we've got some events. Okay, so this is what's going on in your community today on Wednesday. Starting at 11 a.m., we've got a couple stuff going on at Spectrum Discovery Area. The Discovery Bench is sound, and their brain lab is glowing cells. And then they have their Science Sprouts as well, which is it's an early childhood program for kids ages 2 to 5. So you can have the older crowd, and then you got the younger crowd, and that's also at 11. And then another thing at 11 over at the Children's Museum of Missoula is Taekwondo. So people from championship training will come and teach your kid how to be a ninja. Great. Over the Mansfield Center Conference Room, they have a discussion. It's called Exploring Climate Change / Culture in the Mekong Delta. So that's kind of cool. So this is in Vietnam. And so a doctor, Dr. Dan Spencer, spent 3 weeks in there with 17 University of Montana students. And then they're going to share insight about climate change and how the climate change is impacting the region and the people. Over at the Missoula Public Library, they've got a couple things going on, as always. They have their afternoon matinee at the Missoula Main. So that starts at 2 p.m. It is usually a classic film and recent feature at 2 p.m. And then also at 2 is the open hours in the Makerspace. So from 2 to 6, you can work on a project of your choice or learn how to use their equipment. And then over at the Missoula Public Library as well, they have got a preschool scissors clinic. So from 3:30 to 4:30 today, you can bring your little preschooler by, and then they can learn how to use scissors and cut shapes out and make art. It's pretty cute. And then they have middle school writers at 3:30. There's a writing group for grades 6 through 9 to give and get some good feedback, play with words, and eat some chocolate. Over at Taste Buds Kitchen at 4:30, they have a bunny cupcake workshop from 2 to 6. So that is $20. Oh, no, it's ages 2 to 6 at 4:30, $20. And then over at Vespieri Book Restoration and Bindery at 1221 Helen Avenue, they've got a Blizzard bookbinding class. So it'll cover instruction of a unique folded book whimsically called the Blizzard Book. And it was invented during a particularly wild blizzard. Cool, who would have known? 396-1911 is the phone number you can call for more information. Over at the Zootown Arts Community Center, they've got a Bob Ross night. So starting at 6 p.m., you can follow along to a video and make a great painting. So it's $25, and the cost covers all your materials, supplies, and canvas. It's a pretty good deal. Over at the Missoula Public Library, they've got open jewelry in their makerspace. So after the exploration, you can go in there and make some jewelry. That's from 6 to 7:30. Over the Confident Stitch, this is located on Front Street. They have a Learn to Sew Garments Intermediate class. So this is a 5-part class that runs for 5 weeks from 6 to 8 every Wednesday night. And they're going to make a pair of pajamas in the class. Yeah. But, you know, that'll teach you lots of different things that you need to know when making pajamas. So call 540-4068. Or for the Starving Artist community, they have their open mic. That's the Starving Artist Cafe and Art Gallery out on Reserve Street. Starts at 6. And then the Lifelong Learning Center has got a couple language classes. First one is Beginning Japanese. It's $134. It starts at 6, so it's at the Lifelong Learning Center. And then they have an American Sign Language class, also at 6, and that cost is only $67. Over at REI, there's an REI GPS Navigation Basics. This is for handheld GPS uses and devices. So if you've got a handheld one, they ask that you bring it. But they're going to teach you the basics of handheld GPS. So it's at $30 for members, $50 for non-members. You can register at rei.com/Missoula. This next event is kind of fun. There's a garage sale primer starting at 7. So if you are planning on holding a garage sale this summer but don't really know how, or your garage sales are always really lame, some people don't. They're having a class on garage sales. It'll give you tips to turn your ho-hum sale into a dynamite sale.
I'm so glad you read this.
Yeah, some people...
That made my day.
Some people don't know how to garage sale. Some people just have no idea what to do. Why are you laughing?
Because it's hilarious.
Why?
Why not?
Why is it funny,
It's
Scott?
Really funny. It's like, well, if you don't know how to do a garage sale, we'll tell you how to do a garage sale. You sell things from your garage. I was like, huh.
But some people don't know about advertising or when to advertise or how to advertise, you know? Some people just have no idea. Like, Scott, when was the last time you held a garage sale?
I don't have a garage.
See, you have no room. Okay, so that'll be at Hellgate Elementary Middle School at 2385 Flynn Lane. Scott loves this.
Well, it's not as bad as Women in Computers.
Yeah.
The Missoula Public Library hosts Women in Computers.
Yeah.
No.
They don't want men making fun of them.
That's true. I don't blame them.
Okay, so over at Fact and Fiction, there's a reading and signing from C.J. Box's book, Off Ooh. The Grid. And so this is the synopsis. I'm going to read it to you guys. Nate Romanowski is off the grid.
Do you want to start again?
No. Recuperating from wounds and trying to deal with past crimes when he is suddenly confronted by a small team of elite professional special operators. They're not here to threaten him, but to make a deal. They need help destroying a domestic terror cell in the Red Desert, and in return, they'll make Nate's criminal record disappear. Okay, classic. but they are not what they seem, as Joe Pickett discovers. I have no idea who Joe is. They have a much different plan in mind, and it may just be something that takes them all down, including Nate and Joe.
No.
I know. And if there's other collateral damage, that's just the fortunes of war. So that sounds pretty intense. You can read from that and sign it. At Fact and Fiction at 7 tonight. And then my last two events for Wednesday, we've got country dance lessons with instructor Kathy Clark at the Sunrise Saloon at 7 for $5.
Awesome.
And then a dancing concert will be at the University of Montana. I do believe it's the Denison Theater, starting at 7:30, and it's for the next 3 days. But that's what everything I've got for you guys. Up next, we've got a Asaph segment.
Well, we're going to do an old television show from the past known to the world as Davey and Goliath. Not necessarily the biblical version. This is what's called an American clay animation children's television show from the past. There's Davey and there's his dog Goliath. And when you watch this cartoon series, Goliath can talk, but Davey and his world can't hear the dog talk. The only one who can hear him talk is Davey himself and whoever happens to be watching the television show. Yeah. So let's talk about this for a moment. Davey and Goliath is an American clay animated children's television series produced by the Lutheran Church in America, and it was created by Art Clocky and Ruth Clocky and Dick Sutcliffe. They're the same creators of Pokey and Gumbo. You remember when Eddie Murphy did the...
Gumby.
Yeah. Well, anyway, Art Clocky created Gumby too, as well as Davey and Goliath. This is Davey's family here. And What's interesting about this series, I think it was groundbreaking for the time, not only because it was claymation, but the topics they talked about. They talked about racism, death, religious intolerance, vandalism, youth, you know, had a youth audience. And it covered a lot of things. And this is Nathaniel here. He's the first black claymation puppeteer, if that's the right word, to ever appear on a television series of that time. Davey had two black friends, and he was the first one. And I find that interesting that they could cover that. And even the critics were fond of this because they didn't think it was preachy. The critics saw this as tastefully promoting spiritual curiosity of kids, covering topics without it, you know, being very preachy. Let's catch that video and you can catch Davey in action here.
You're right, children. All of you who will be good neighbors, come and get your balloons. Great big balloons. Oh, boy. Oh, boy. Who is our neighbor, Davey?
I'll get you loose.
In this clip here, Davey is learning to be what's called a good neighbor. And I think that's interesting that they can teach children how to be kind to people. And of course, Davey does a kind deed by helping this little girl and sends her home. And the kids get balloons from the mayor for being good neighbors. So that's what this particular episode was about. But finally, this show premiered January 1st, 1960, and it lasted until 1965. That's pretty incredible for that time period there. And then, of course, in 1971 and 1973 and 1975, they added some new characters, even though it was off television. You know, you might see it like it was similar to Schoolhouse Rock. You know how they would like put it on? And eventually after this left television, it just showed like here and there, like on Sunday mornings, usually like that. And so they did like some Christmas episodes and things like that. But overall, if you have little children, this is a great, you know, thing to expose your children to. And I'll stop right there.
Nice. Thanks, Asaph.
So, did you used to watch this show when you were
young? Yes, I did. I used to actually watch this growing up before going to Sunday school as a little boy.
Cool. How did this show speak to you?
Well, you know, when you're a kid, you just like the special effects with the claymation. But when you get a little older, you get familiar with the message. The
Didn't Gumby and Davey and Goliath cross over a couple times?
Yeah, they did, because it was made by the same creator.
Oh,
yeah.
Did they?
Yeah. I remember a couple of those episodes where, like, Gumby was, like, walking around doing his Gumby thing.
Yeah, and he would do little nice things with a little talking horse, and here is just Davey and his talking horse.
And the cool thing about Gumby
thing.
Is that he had the power to, like, jump into books, and then you go into different worlds, basically.
That's correct.
Gumby was time traveler.
Yeah.
See? And
time
of course,
traveler, literary, he's basically like all those things that a lot of shows base off of in terms of like getting into the books or getting into different worlds, different times.
Yeah, but that's good for an imagination if you're a child to watch Davey and Goliath and of course Gumby. So I think that Art Clokey just made some great clay animation cartoons at that time. Just great imagination for kids.
Cool. Thanks, Asaph. That was Musical Notes with Asaph Adonai, and we'll be right back after this.
Thank you.
Okay, so this is what's going on tomorrow. And tomorrow has a whole bunch of stuff. I was really surprised. Tomorrow's got a ton of going on.
It's always the second day.
It really is. Yeah. And so, but we start off pretty much with a bunch of kids' activities. So we have a few activities to get you ready for your kids' activities. So we have a Community Champions Day over at Missoula Aging Services. It starts at 9 a.m. Public officials help deliver Meals on Wheels to homebound seniors and people with disabilities. So that is happening all week long. Way to go, public figures. And then over at the Sacred Roots Healing Arts Studio, they've got their Mindful Movement and Meditation class at 10 a.m. You can find yourself grounded and centered within before you start your day. So it's Tuesdays to Thursdays, 10:15 to 11:30, and you have to bring your own accessories like mats and props and blankets. 801 Sherwood Street. It's called 647-6485. And then if you take that tomorrow, that'll get you geared up to send your kids to all of these activities. So starting at 10:30 is Tiny Tales at the Missoula Public Library. Babies ages birth through 3 years will sing songs, learn finger plays, and hear nursery rhymes. We have Family Fun Time at Mismo Gymnastics at 10:30. This is an open gym for ages walking to 12 years. Then we've got a preschool playgroup over at Roots Acro Sports Center at 11. This is for ages walking to 5 years. Oh, the first one. Okay, let me rewind. Okay, Family Fun Time, Mismo Gymnastics, ages walking to 12 years. I don't know if I said that. I feel like I said 5. And then preschool playgroup is at Roots Acro Sports Center, and that's ages walking to 5 years. And that's where they set up different stations around the gym, and then parents and children get to rotate and choose what they want to do. So it's $8 a drop-in, $12 for siblings. And then over at Spectrum Discovery Area, the Discovery Bench is Spin, and the Brain Lab is Fruit Fly Fun. It's at 11. Also at 11 is Family Yoga at the Children's Museum of Missoula. And then over at the Missoula Insectarium, we skip from 11 all the way up to 3. Kids are in school, you know. So over at the Missoula Insectarium at 3 o'clock, they have an early out activity, Arthropod Leg Anatomy. You can visit the Insectarium and discover the diversity of arthropod legs and their different forms and functions. Yeah. And then we go into Electronics Exploration at the Missoula Public Library at 3. From 3 to 6, you can go in there and work on a project of your choice or check out their different platforms. And then also at 3:30 at the public library, we've got Lego Club. This is for ages 12 and under, have to be accompanied by an adult, but they provide Lego and Duplo pieces for you. And then we go across the street to Missoula Insectarium at 3:30 for spider feeding. They're feeding Rosie the Chilean Rosehair Tarantula. And then we've got a downtown drop-in wine tasting that is at 5 o'clock at La Grotta Bella. It's 12:50. They say it's 12:50. It says that it's $10 online, but it's not anymore. So it's a minimum of 4 wines and a different theme each week. And then over the Lifelong Learning Center, they've got another language class that starts Thursdays. It's a beginning conversational Mandarin. It's $134. It starts at 6. And text is required but not included in the tuition. Over at the Barn Movement Studio, they're having an African dance class at 6. This is located at 2926 South 3rd Street West with suggested donation of $5. And then the Good Food Store has got a cooking class. It's called Confidence in the Kitchen, Good Food, Great Gadgets. So it's $25, 6:30, starts at 6:30 tomorrow. And so they're going to prepare terrific seasonal dishes using really great gadgets. You're going to learn all about what knives and cutting boards and all the cool things you can buy for your kitchen. They're going to make an artisan cheese plate, a poached egg and bacon salad, butternut squash soup with coconut milk, miso, and lime. Mm. They're going to do buttered chicken with steamed rice, baked pears with honey thyme butter, and cream fraiche. Oh my gosh. There's a poetry slam at E3 Convergence Gallery at 7 p.m. You can go a little early and sign up in the door, but poets must be ready with at least 3 poems to compete. Aww. And the show is all ages, so they ask that you just kind of be a little bit mindful of your poetry. But I think that takes all the fun out of it. The Roxy Theater is showing a movie. It's called The Clean Bin Project. It starts at 7 tomorrow night. And this is put on by the International Wildlife Film Festival. And so The Clean Bin Project is a movie about a regular couple and their quest to answer the question, is it possible to live completely waste-free? So this couple, argues and tries to cut down on waste. It's basically social commentary on waste. Yeah. Should be funny. There is a focus on sparrows in an advanced birding class starting at 7 at Montana Fish, Wildlife, and Parks. Cost is $15 per session. To sign up, you can call 549-5632. Over at Roots Acro Sports Center, they have adult trampoline and tumble from 7:30 to 8:30. So from ages 16 and up, you can spend $8 to drop in and just jump around on trampolines and fly around. Yeah, sounds awesome. And then we've got a bunch of music. So there's Trivia at the Holiday Inn at 7:30, Trivia at the Lucky Strike at 8. And then this next band, I think Scott would really enjoy the name. It's called Stomp the Cat Box.
Ooh.
That's at the Sunrise Saloon at 8.
I like it.
I know, isn't that funny? Open mic at the Eagles Lodge at 8:30, open mic at the Broadway at 9, Dead History at the Badlander at 9, karaoke at the Dark Horse at 9, the big gig is at the Palace at 9:30. This is consists of 4 different bands and musicians. And then Corey Quinn is playing at the Top Hat Lounge at 10, and he is folk music. So that's what's going on in your community. As always, you can check out MissoulaEvents.net, the University of Montana website, the Missoulian, or the Independent for more events. But we'll be right back after this next arts clip.
And that's all at the Gallery of the Visual Arts at the University of Montana's Social Science Buildings. Of course, we've been showing you all sorts of wonderful and crazy clips from there. And that basically completes the 3 videos that basically encompass of what's going on with the Gallery of Visual Arts. But what's up next is we're talking about some city council. And what I thought was going to be a lot about the mercantile, turned out it's going to be a lot more about the Parking Commission's emergency ordinance, which basically, it states is that they want to implement a new ordinance in place of the kiosks, which there weren't any language for the kiosks, but there were language for the meters. So there's a difference between meters and kiosks, but they wanted to pass this ordinance fast enough so they could start charging people for wrongfully parking. Basically. Okay, so let's start off with a little bit of the mercantile. And this is Jeff Stevens again, and he has a little brief quote that basically kind of encompasses how he feels about how the city's gone forward with Homebase.
Now, new hotels in Missoula have become something of a commonplace, and there are probably more in the pipeline, whether this one gets built or not. They sort of spring up like mushrooms in a damp cellar. They want to do a deconstruction of the mercantile. That's an interesting word. It's a classic weasel word, the kind developers love to use when they plan to tear something down. It's applied like a local anesthetic to mask the pain when they slip the dagger in. It might hurt less, but in the end, the patient is dead.
All right, so that's basically how he feels about that. And we had Kayla Black give another comment about, and she's from the Historic Preservation, and she's basically stating that they're doing a Historic Preservation Committee just for this specific mercantile up until the demolition permit gets passed up in June. So the demolition permit is going to be discussed up in June. That's when they're actually going to do it. But of course, they're still looking for people to rally support. And if you are interested in being there, whether you support it or not, or you want some kind of involvement with the future of the corner of Higgins and Main, you can log on to their Facebook page. It's Save the Merc, and they can tell you all the information about that. That's, you know, just to get it out there and whatnot. Okay, so this next thing I want to talk about is okay, the emergency ordinance was put into place to take action, and you know, some people are just kind of frustrated with the downtown parking area. And this is Ms. Schultz, and of course, she didn't say her first name. This is how I'm introducing her in this clip.
What the public has to say at the public hearing, changing the ordinance is a done deal, so appearing on the 4th or contacting our council persons before that date is an exercise in futility. The new parking meters and the increased rate to park on the street and in the parking garage have just been shoved down our throats. I, for one, will shop elsewhere than downtown. I'm informed that Boise did away with their parking meters downtown to increase the use of downtown, so it seems to me that Missoula is being regressive rather than progressive.
All right, and that's what she had to say about the not only the parking ordinance, but the everything beyond the parking in downtown Missoula. And I understand
the whole general compass.
Okay, here is Dean McCollin, and he talks about the word emergency as it applies to the ordinance.
Really? Furthermore, based on the city ordinance currently in effect, the Parking Commission had and has no legal authority to collect payment for meter time or fines for violations occurring on the new Luke kiosk meters. These funds should all be refunded as well. That's the end of my comment.
Yeah, and that's basically what he had to say about that. The next quote I have is from Jeff Badenoch, who is the interim director of the Parking Commission. He's the one that took over after Anne Guest basically had her mic drop moment. So this is Jeff Badenoch, and this is what he had to say about the parking structure and about how important this new ordinance is.
But now we need to have the city ordinance reflect reality. Otherwise, how will people know what they're expected to do, what the law expects them to do when it comes to parking? Now we have, with this change, a description of what the parking reality is on the street. And citizens will know what's the correct way to park, how to pay for parking, and what the penalties for not parking correctly are. I understand the frustration about the use of the word emergency. We consulted with the city attorney's office about the appropriateness of this. In the past, the city has passed emergency ordinances that aren't exactly the same kind of an emergency as, say, a flood that takes out Higgins Avenue Bridge or other things. But they are emergencies because the implementation of the laws is timely, necessary, and for the benefit of the people of Missoula. This is the way that we viewed this change. It is.
All right, so that's what he had to say about that. So what I'm actually wondering, Noelle and Asaph, is with this new emergency ordinance that was put into place, why do you think they're actually putting the wording after the fact they put the new kiosks in?
Well, I think that they, I don't know.
That's a good question.
Yeah, I think it's a good question, but also what that other public comment was, like, if they don't have the correct wording, so then can we get our money back? I mean, are they really legally allowed to charge us and ticket us when they don't have the correct wording in the ordinance?
Yeah, for the last couple of months, if you got a ticket, you didn't actually necessarily have to pay for it if you actually challenged it, because the ordinance did not reflect the kiosks.
And what about paying the meters, paying the kiosks?
Now well, we'll get to that.
I want my money back.
We'll talk about the motion in terms of the emergency ordinance. So, of course, people why now? Why are we doing this? Why is this kind of, like, important? Of course, Jim Nugent, basically. All right, where is Jim Nugent? Okay, we're going to have Jim Nugent on here. And Jim Nugent is the legal counsel for the city of Missoula, and he's been doing this for like over 30 years.
Oh,
and he's basically the backbone of what the city is in terms of policy and laws and all that stuff. So this is Jim Nugent, and he explains why the level of emergency is important to this specific ordinance.
First of all, the normal process is a minimum of 44 days from tonight because regular ordinances don't go into effect immediately. It takes 30 days by state law before a regular ordinance goes into effect. Second answer is the city council determines emergency, not our office. And it's up to the city council to decide if they think it's an emergency. And if we had told Jeff no, then someone would have probably been saying, why didn't you let him come forward with an emergency proposal? It's the city council's decision to decide if this is an emergency.
All right, so of course, Jim Nugent passes it over to the city. But of course, basically explaining this is very interesting for sure. Emily Bentley, I think she basically encompasses the frustrations of a lot of people in the downtown area about the parking. And then I'll explain exactly how things went down and to clarify some of this stuff as I'm building to it.
Commission that we had no say whatsoever in the new kiosks that were going in. And indeed, since then, we haven't really weighed in at all. We haven't really gotten a chance. And so the first time that we are, and it turns out there's an ordinance governing it, and that wasn't brought up at that meeting 2 years ago. And so now we're being asked to do something that's, you know, doesn't feel that great. It's the first time we get to vote on this issue. I wouldn't have voted for the kiosk in the first place. So now I'm forced to vote for this emergency ordinance, which I probably will do because I don't want to have chaos in downtown Missoula. And it seems like my hands are tied. Oh, and by the way, everyone else who doesn't like the kiosk, they don't blame the parking commission. They blame the city council. And so that's my frustration. And that's my frustration with this whole process. And I wish that the parking commission had come to us a year ago and said, this is going to be a really strange process. What is your recommendation and what would make you feel most comfortable? I'm probably going to support it. Like I said, I don't want to create havoc in downtown Missoula, but I'm very frustrated.
Oh, but of course, the city council did support this, and of course, the emergency ordinance did pass for the sake of forwarding the kiosks home in Missoula, in downtown Missoula. So the idea, of course, you know, rates have gone up for parking to, they haven't gone up for like 60 plus years or whatever, so it really hasn't much change. But with this major change, I don't know about you, but it's pretty confusing, but it does reflect the parking downtown. Mm-hmm. My concern with the ordinance is, why wasn't the part of the preliminary stuff, like why didn't you do this, like why are you doing production of these kiosks? Why wasn't this something that, and one of the answers that was given to us was basically you couldn't change the word in the ordinance because we already had the meters still in place. And officially, just this last week, all the meters were taken out and all the kiosks were put in.
Nope. I parked on a street yesterday that had all meters and no kiosks.
Really?
Yep. It's on Woody Street and in between Orange Street and it's in between Woody and Orange Street.
Really?
It's this tiny little street. It's got all meters and no kiosks.
Interesting.
Yep. I know. I was like, whoa, is this?
Yeah, it's just really real. Weird.
So I just put money in and parked and I was fine. Yeah. I know. So I was like, no, it's not.
Yep.
City, so the idea of the, get your stuff together.
Yeah. So the idea of this emergency ordinance, is put into place because the motion did indeed pass. It is now that it's more enforceable. The idea is like, because Jim Nugent was basically saying that with any other ordinance, it basically means that if an ordinance gets passed by the city, it usually takes about 44 days to actually get implemented. So it takes a while.
Yeah.
So that's why they did the emergency ordinance, just for the sake of just like, we got to start charging people fees, and if they challenge it, now they can't challenge it anymore.
Emergency is a sexy term. Emergency ordinance, are you serious? Like, that sounds really hardcore.
Yeah, it is. Yeah. It is a sexy term.
But it's not hardcore. It's not as, like, as an emergency as people think. They hear emergency, like, don't use emergency ordinance unless it's a real emergency. That's what that word is for.
But But it all comes down to the fact that the city, it was basically out of their hands. A lot of this was on the parking commission.
And so what?
The parking commission was like this: Hey, city, we're gonna the parking meters are old. We want to deal with this, and we want to take things and you know like work with them and get rid of the meters because they're old and we don't have enough parts to replace them. It's like, okay, just do what you do. It was like, okay, we'll just do what we do. We're gonna change the meters, and that was like 2 years ago.
Okay.
And then they finally got the new meters in just last December, and people were just like, what? And then of course I did a meeting like in February leading up to that December where they put in the new kiosk, where they actually had the people who bid the new kiosks, the loop meters, the blah 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 meter, the New York meter, whatever, all these different types of meters were basically meters. Selling to Missoula to see whether or not, oh, would this meter be good for us, would this meter be bad for us, and yeah, I mean, they've had so many public meetings and so many open things, and it's funny, city government, wouldn't it be great if city government were to email the people who are opposed to this first and foremost?
Yeah.
It's like they have a list of people who are opposed to things and they have to email them specifically, otherwise they would come into the meetings like, I didn't hear about this.
Yeah.
So then that way,
I just think it would be nice if we had more of a like, you know, city council is public, but I guess I think it would be nice if we had more of like a, if city council meetings were just like, I guess if this was information was like more widely available or like available easier or available with more accessibility to like a younger crowd, because like people our age like don't know anything about this. No one I know goes to city council.
I'm glad you bring that up, because you guys can find out more information by logging on to the City of Missoula's website, www.ci.missoula.mt.us. Oh, sorry, it was already there. I was looking at the left meter and I thought that was live. And you have this wonderful page. You can search Missoula and find out everything that's going on here. Meetings, more, PDFs. The PDFs are just wonderful. So you go to your government. Let's zoom in a little more. So you go to your government. You go down to city council. And you go to Agenda, Webcasts, and Minutes. You click on here. I'll zoom out just a little bit.
It takes a little bit for the actual meetings to pop up.
And it gives you a nice little grid sheet of exactly what you can expect from future meetings. So let's zoom in a little more on this. So the hyperlinks are linked to the agendas. You get a nice little agenda page. Not there. But the idea is that you get a nice little page where basically gives you the rundown of what's going on with city meetings. And of course, if it has MP3 or MP4, it has access to the video that was made. So if you don't see MP3 or MP4, that meeting hasn't happened yet. Or if the date doesn't match if the date is already passed, that means the meeting was probably canceled or missed. But you know, it's a great resource for people to go on and watch it and make their own city council report, like I just did.
Yay! Woo! City council! It's just nice to be informed. It's just nice to be informed in the city of Missoula. And you know, if you want to make a difference, you have to start locally.
Yeah. So. But of course, I want to do another art clip, because it is, we have four art clips that are basically going to expire by the end of this week, and I want you guys to check all this art out live. But of course, here's a little tease from the Clay Studio, which will be ending this Saturday.
Thank you.
again, that's the Clay Studio, which is a wonderful place to go where you can also make your own art as well. And the Gallery of the Visual Arts is celebrating a bunch of the college kids this year by showing a whole bunch of different types of art, which we've shown throughout the show. So today is more of an artsy show with a little bit of, with a little spice of government in there, just thrown in there. But of course, it is Wednesday, and like always on Wednesday, we do our favorite all-time favorite game we like to play. Are you guys ready to play Hallmark or Bullmark?
Yes, I can't wait.
Let's do this then. Oh, wait, sorry. All right, hit it, Asaph. When Cass, a single mother, of course, and a high-powered attorney, she's also a high-powered attorney, just making that clear, hires Matt, a family friend, as a nanny out of desperation. Sparks fly in this tale about being there for family and being there for the heart. As Matt begins to bond with Cass's kids, sparks begin to fly between workaholic Cass and the hunky Matt. But just when things become clear, Cass begins to question her heart. Can Cass open her heart for this friend turned father figure?
Oh no.
And this movie's called All Yours. Is this a Hallmark original movie, or is this complete Bullmark? So, just so you guys know, I read a synopsis from a Hallmark original movie, or do I? And you guys have to determine whether or not it's real or not.
Or if you made it up.
So if it's real, it's Hallmark. If it's fake, it's Bullmark.
Okay, so this is like classic Hallmark movie. Classic. So I'm gonna say Bullmark.
I'm gonna say Bullmark.
Yeah, because it's so classic.
I really hate to tell you this, but it's in a Hallmark original movie.
Oh! Okay.
Yes, it is a Hallmark original movie.
It, okay.
Yeah.
I knew it.
I'm happy about that. I'm very
Hallmark.
Happy about that.
Mm-hmm. Of course, he always falls in love with the kids first. That's how it happens.
He's a family friend.
He's a family guy.
Yeah. Okay, you guys ready?
Father figure. Okay, yes.
Hit it, Asaph. I gotta stop doing Jimmy Fallon. Okay, Claire, an ambitious pastry chef, is busy running her new restaurant, but her meddling mom is preoccupied with her lack of love life. Without her knowledge, Claire's mother finds her the perfect man. As sparks fly, Claire's mom can't help but take credit, and Claire begins to question her mother and her new guy. Maybe the by chance romance was set up, but were their feelings really there? And this movie is called Love by Chance. Is this a Hallmark original movie, or is this complete hogwash, otherwise known as Bullmark?
I'm gonna say Bullmark.
Are you gonna say Bullmark?
I'm gonna say Bullmark again.
Yep.
I win. It's a Hallmark original movie.
Good, Scott!
I totally cleared the playing field. I was just like, you guys are dead.
Yeah, Scott rocks this time.
I rule this time.
He rules.
Congratulations. Good job, Scott.
I'm admitting to Noah.
Well, because if you understand that if one of them is Hallmark and one of them is Bullmark, that's usually how I've been doing it. But this time I'm doing a double Hallmark realistic special.
Oh my gosh.
So as my reward, I'm going to end the show on my face.
No.
Hey, as a guy.
No.
Do. Get out of here. I just like pretend to play piano as like Asaph song, Asaph closing song. Even though that's not even like close to how it turns out. Okay. Now my audio is back down to
to
passable.
Normal. To passable.
Well, thanks guys for joining us. We had
a
great
super fun
time on our show today, and you can find out more information by logging on to wakeupmissoula.wix.com/wakeupmissoula. You can find us on Facebook. You can follow us on Twitter.
You can like MCAT on Twitter at MCATTVMissoula. You can like MCAT on Facebook, and to find out more information about us, check us out on MCAT.org.
And of course, if you or an organization wants to talk about any upcoming events, causes, or concerts, you can call us at 542-6228, otherwise known as 542-MCAT. Or if you're too scared, you can email us MCAT@MCAT.org.
Yep.
Without further ado, for Wake Up Missoula, I am Scott Ramph.
And I am Noelle McFoy, and here is Asaph Adonai. Thanks, everyone, and we'll see you Friday.
Goodbye.